My grandfather, not my poppy, my mother's father. Very, very, very old school, old New York Italian. No filter whatsoever. Would tell me all the time how beautiful I was. I had beautiful black hair. I had a nice figure from the waist up, but forget it, your legs down, they're too big. Your legs are too big. A part of me still said, I don't care. I like it. This is who I am. You know, I just see a lot of different celebrities that, or models that have no athletic background whatsoever representing major athletic lines. To me, that's an insult. I'm a professional fighter, I'm a world champion, I'm a female boxer, and I still have to struggle to get this recognition, to get what I deserve. I was always an athlete and I was always an artist, right out of the womb. I did everything. I was very much a girly tomboy. And the very first sport I fell in love with was baseball. And I wanted to be a professional baseball player when I grew up. And I was told at 5 years old I couldn't because I was a girl. I was always naturally very muscular as a kid. I was always solid. From a little girl, I got made fun of a lot. In fourth grade, I'll remember they called me Thunder Thighs and I used to cry. Oh my gosh, they used to call me Big Al. I was the only girl on the team and I was the only one that hit home runs out of all those boys. I do remember being on the playground crying by myself. I mean, I was 120 pounds in fourth grade, but I was solid. I wasn't a fat kid. I was solid. I was muscular. But I was never one of those girls in school that the popular guy was like, I gotta date Alicia. I was more like their friend. I'm more womanly. They don't like curve. They don't like big legs. Without that adversity, I wouldn't be as strong as I am today. Jeans are still a struggle. I hate jeans. You need to make some jeans for some curve. I cannot wear low-rider jeans. I remember being in that dressing room like this. It was a struggle. I was on the wrestling team. And I was the second girl to join. I joined because I heard the coach talking about the first girl joining and that girl shouldn't join. So I joined. They definitely would tease us or maybe not take us seriously. And I wrestled one boy from Manitouk. I beat him, he cried. And they tried to kick me off my team. We'd have to like switch on and off and partner with each other and wrestle. Everybody had to wrestle each other. And one boy tried to pull my sports bra down. I got up and I kicked him in his stomach as hard as I could. I just started beating the crap out of him. Forget wrestling. I just took it to the street. I will mess you up. Respect me. I won almost all my matches. I remember fathers coming up to me saying, I had my daughter watch you. You were great. That gave me the confidence, I think, to stick up for myself more and more. The third time I was in a male-dominated sport, because first was baseball, then was karate, and then wrestling in junior high school. And after that came boxing. The biggest fight in that ring is always fighting yourself. It's not the person in front of you. Anything that I was fearful of failing, I had to do it until I accomplished it. Fear, if you let it, will control you. And I don't like that feeling. I won 11 national titles in the amateur games. Then my last Golden Gloves, I said, you know what, I'm gonna go pro. The second I turned pro, it was like, it fit like a glove. I was able to be myself, I was able to be the artist. My hardest fight was my last fight against Tori Nelson. We were both undefeated. She had 10 world titles. I had one. She was like 17-0, and I was 7-0. And I went to her hometown. I had all the odds against me, and I went the distance with her all 10 rounds. It was a dogfight, and she won. It was a pain that I've never felt before. My heart has been tremendously broken in life and in relationships, and even that could not compare to that. But I don't believe in losses, I believe in lessons. So I'm okay with it. I am 100% okay with it because I'm gonna fight her again and I'm gonna beat her. Some girls are intimidated. They don't want to get too involved in the sport because they're scared of looking muscular or masculine. You shouldn't be fearful of making your body strong. It's a beautiful thing, and that's what we're meant to do. You're gonna build up your body. It's a woman's body, it's not a man's body. So how's it gonna look masculine? You look strong. That pisses me off. It's like, I gotta wash that brain. Gotta slap the society out of you. I always feel beautiful inside and out. I don't know, I never had a moment where I really feel most beautiful. I just feel beautiful all the time. I'm at a place where I accept who I am. I love who I am, whether you like it or not. My name is Alicia, the Empress Napoleon. I'd like to dispel the myth that muscles are for men. They are for women. Muscles are meant to be strong, meant to be built up. Strong is the new sexy.